in Hungary where the boar run free, and when they stop doing that, they end up here, in restaurants. Tamás from Wonderheart Hunting has asked his restaurant-owning friend if Kai could come and see how to cook a traditional Hungarian wild boar dish.
So already, I've shot a young pig, a piglet, sizes and everything, and a yearling ewe, another small lamb. Now, we come here to the restaurant, Tamás's friend, Pipak's restaurant. We're going to do traditional Hungarian cuisine. Now, I'm hoping it's going to influence some of my cooking back at home. I already use a lot of paprika, and I use a lot of some of their ingredients. We're going to see what the chef, Zoltan, in the kitchen can show me.
To add some authenticity, we're taking over the pavement, but we start in the kitchen.
There we go. While we'll be doing the stuff outside, we've also got another traditional dish being cooked inside the kitchen, and that's wild boar cheek with cabbage and bacon. Fantastic this is. It's so good. It's got the cabbage with the sour cream. And I've noticed these are sour cream a lot in Hungarian cooking. The Hungarian style gnocchi without Parmesan cheese. This is just with eggs, flour, potato, seasoning. You've got the confit wild boar cheeks, roasted tomatoes, cress, leaves, parsley. Absolutely fantastic.
The eating of game is such an important part of what we hunters do, and we need to do it well, otherwise deep-fried roadkill will never inspire others to partake.
The meat's now browned, it's been cooking for a little bit, so the next stage, put the seasoning in and get the rest of the ingredients in as well. So, Zoltan, what's going to go in first? Tomato? Yep. Nice, fresh, juicy tomatoes. Only half. White pepper? It's inspired me to do some kind of street food-esque style recipes. I'm going to play around with using wild boar, mouflon or lamb. So it's given me a lot of ideas and inspirations. So I'm really excited to go home now, just get in the kitchen and do some bits.
Having been guided by the experts, Kai is now going to create his own boar dish. It's not Hungarian boar, but from meat specialists Kezi's.
Today we're using the Dutch oven. It's ideal for cooking outdoors, it's designed for cooking outdoors over campfires and take really traditionally people used to take these out on horseback. I've got one large onion here. Three cloves of garlic. I've got peppers, I've got green and yellow peppers. Now traditionally in Hungary they've got white peppers, but in our supermarkets you buy a lot of funky colour peppers. I've got green and yellow. You don't have to have wild boar in your back garden on one of your permissions. Here, from Kezi Meat Supplies, we've got some nice diced boar. One thing I'd say about Kezi, they're absolutely fantastic on their delivery. From Scotland, you can get it next day delivery from here in Kent. So if you fancy a barbecue the next day, look at the weather, and it's looking good, and you fancy something a bit more exotic, then why not give them a call, order, and you can get yourself whatever species you want. They tend to do crocodile, python, you can get anything from venison, you name it, you can get it from them. So what I'm doing now, I'm softening the onions, the peppers and the garlic, and I'm also just searing the meat, browning off slightly. Then I'll add the tomatoes and some of the spices and some of the liquid. I'm going to put in the tomatoes. These are vine tomatoes. Now while that's cooking, I'm just going to put a tablespoon and a half of Hungarian sweet paprika. I'm going to add about 300 grams of just beef stock, nice rich beef stock that should complement the boar. I'm just going to top it up with some water, maybe about half a pint or so. Now last but not least, we've got about a glass full of red wine left in this bottle. It's actually Hungarian wine. Oh, it smells lovely. Now we're going to pop it into the Dutch oven and then that will be us done. So we're going to cook it there, reduce it down till the meat's nice and soft and tender. Keep checking it, but it's going to take about 2 hours for that to cook. We'll just have a lovely, hearty, Hungarian style stew later on for dinner. Now, if you want any carbohydrate with this, you can put a potato, wrap it in foil, put it in the embers, give jacket potato for later on, or put a little pot on the side and cook some rice. This is perfect if you've gone camping. You want to go out for the afternoon for a few hours, you can leave it hanging, as long as it's in a safe place. A few logs underneath, it'll survive off the embers and just keep it warm.
So there you have it, wild boar with a hint of Hungary, a soupçon of Kent and a dash of Wales. Truly international cuisine. If you want to shoot and eat wild boar in Hungary, best drop Tamás a line. Go to wonderheart.co.uk.